Investigators believe he's driving a four-door Mazda SUV with California tags. It's approaching 7:26. The CARES Act say
he was on a morning walk near Pleasant Hill Road. Today's Natalie Foltz has more from Gwinnett Police Headquarters. Natalie, good morning to you.
Well, good morning to you guys. You know, it's when, where, and how this all happened that's really bothersome. It wasn't in a dark, secluded area at nighttime. It was around 9 o'clock in the morning. The sun was up. It was light outside. So Gwinnett County Police, they're just hoping by releasing this sketch that it'll trigger someone's memory in regards to what was going on, and they'll come forward with some information. Scary. Us to today's hot topic question. What causes you to unfollow someone? Actually, so many of you are saying this is not something that you would ever do. Crystal says, I don't usually unfriend people. I can handle different opinions. On the other hand, I have been unfriended by many, usually as soon as I disagreed with them. Valentino says, I can't imagine unfriending someone over posts that I don't agree with. Everyone has a right to their own views, voices, opinions, beliefs. We don't have to agree on everything. Benjamin says, I don't have anybody to unfriend because I trust and believe them at first before adding them as a friend. And Steven's comment made me laugh. He says, if it's constant nonsense, I'll unfollow them. If they're jerks all the time, I'll unfriend them, but never block. I want them to see that they've been removed. All right, so we want to get your take on this. You can head to our Fox 5 and let a Facebook.
The Senate majority can radically change America. The Schumer, Pelosi, Ossoff change, defund police, voting rights for illegal immigrants, Washington, D.C. as the 51st state.
Then we change America. Change is coming to America.
Believe them.
Was rushed, and so they were not going to get the vaccine for that reason. 26% said, yeah, I'm going to get the vaccine, but I'm going to wait and make sure that it's safe. And then 12% just don't trust vaccines in general, they said, so they will not be getting the vaccine. And then another 10% said, yes, maybe I'll get that vaccine, not now, because I want to wait and see how effective it is or how well it works. So you have a lot of people, at least, with that kind of wait and see approach about the vaccine.
So the first shot, Beth, could be available as early as December. Do we know how much vaccine that we'll have at that point, and really who will end up getting those first doses?
So we're still waiting to see if Moderna and Pfizer will get that emergency use authorization approval for their vaccine, which allows them to speed up the release of the vaccine or the approval process in an emergency like a pandemic like this. We're still waiting on that. It could come as soon as, you know, in the next few days, maybe even the next few weeks. So we could have about enough vaccine in the, you know, in December into January to vaccinate a little over 20 million Americans. You have to remember that we need to have two shots. So you would have, you know, they'll have, I think, almost close to 50 million doses of the vaccine, but that's only going to vaccinate just over 20 million Americans because we're going to need those two shots.
Mm-hmm, we will.
To another one in Walton County, smaller. We're told by the Secretary of State's office that all three of those counties will upload their new numbers into the system, but it shouldn't change the overall results here in Georgia.
There were several spots where the human beings who were running it didn't follow the procedure.
It's happened again. For the second time in 2 days, a major screw-up was discovered during Georgia's election hand audit. More than 2,700 votes in Fayette County originally weren't counted.
We noticed that there was more people on the absentee ballot file for voting in person in Fayette County than was in the actual reportings.
The new total knocks President-elect Biden's Georgia lead over President Trump to just under 13,000 votes. A day earlier, a similar mistake was found in Floyd County, which failed to count more than 2,500 votes.
This is a slightly different situation from Floyd. These were scanned votes that are on a memory card, whereas Floyd were a box of unscanned votes.
We know that there are approximately 25 to 2,700 votes missing. We just don't know which of those paper ballots it is.
Floyd officials spent yesterday rescanning 8,000 early ballots as it and other counties rushed to meet tonight's 11:59 deadline to complete the audit. Most of the counties are ahead of schedule and have found few, if any, errors. 57 say their vote totals haven't changed at all. 21 were off by one, and 32 off by single digits. The Secretary of State's office says the results shows rumors of rampant election fraud are unfounded.
The human beings that are part of this are the weakest link in the whole system. But that's why there's these checks and double checks and triple checks.
As a result of what happened in Floyd County, the Secretary of State's office was calling for the local election director to resign. Now, he's not technically on the job right now because he's contracted COVID-19, but we have learned that Floyd County officials are planning on holding a meeting tomorrow for what they describe as personnel issues. Reporting live from outside the state capitol in downtown, I'm Mark Teichner for Good Day Atlanta.
Mark, thank you. President Trump has fired the country's top election security official. Christopher Krebs was director of the Cybersecurity and Infrastructure Security Agency. Krebs was voted.
A major retailer, Walmart, admits some stores are having trouble stocking up on these supplies, but they say they're more prepared this time around. One psychologist says one of the big reasons panic buying happens is, well, because of other people.
Research shows that an episode of panic buying lasts 7 to 10 days. So if you want to get ahead of the crowd, what you need to do is back off, hold off. If you can hold on for a few days, if you can hold on for a week or so, then you get to the store, the crowds will have gone, the shelves would have been restocked, and you can get your toilet paper and cans of beans and so forth.
And as you heard Dr. Taylor say right there, that average episode of panic buying does last 7 to 10 days. Mardi Gras in New Orleans will look different next year. That's because the city announced parades will not be allowed. On its website, the city says parades have proven to be super spreader events for COVID-19. Bourbon Street in the French Quarter will be open for Mardi Gras, but state and local COVID guidelines will have to be followed at all times there to try to keep everyone safe. That is a look at your headlines. Katie, I'll send it back to you.
Nice place to park your vehicle, don't you think? Right in front of the wheelchair ramp. I have a question for you. Why do you continue to hold back on the stimulus checks and the unemployment money that should have been released months ago, but you continue to hold back? Why do you do that? Huh? Why do you do that? Answer that question. 557 North Highland Avenue. Come and get your scooter off of private property and pick those others up down there while you're at it. This sidewalk's too small for scooters. Here's another scooter they need to come and get. Seminole and Sinclair Avenue at the daycare center. Hey, Bird. Y'all need to come get this thing. Claiborne Terrace and Seminole Avenue. Little 5-point side of Freedom Parkway. California.
$1 billion in relief money, which is connected to the coronavirus shutdown, went to companies that Congress said double dipped, meaning single businesses got multiple of these Paycheck Protection Program loans. Businesses in March started shutting down. We know that all across the country, the economy for all intents and purposes shut down. So these life-saving loans were offered up to businesses to help stay afloat. But again, a congressional committee finds that nearly 11,000 loans were ID'd to have gone to businesses twice. But there's more. Investigators find that $96 million in loans went to companies that weren't even allowed to do business with the government. Fraud was expected in this situation. The government had to make really fast funding decisions. They got it to the states who had to craft software and get it out as fast as they could. So they knew that there would be holes in the nets. Businesses were in peril. They had to do what they had to do. The feds, even states, again, knew that there would be fraud, but the investigations have now begun. Elise?
I remember in the beginning that you said that for some, they had like a week to try to get a system in place. That's asking a lot of people.
It was asking a lot. So that's why the audit is on now. And I just saw this press release that came up. Seven charged. This is coming from the Department of Justice. Seven charged in connection with COVID relief fraud scheme involving more than 80 fraudulent loan applications. And this alone is worth $16 million. It looks like these folks are coming out of Texas. Mm-hmm. So charges are starting to be filed. They're taking very seriously this double dipping and who got loans who were not supposed to get loans. So the audit has begun.
Mm-hmm. Sounds like they are on top of this, and so are you. Dana, thanks so much. We appreciate it.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it, folks.